Thank you. welcome to my recital. It is so exciting for me to see people in person and to share this program with you in person and for the people online. Each piece on this program tonight was written by mostly living composers. Three out of four of them are still alive. And even though these pieces are technically from the same time period, classified as 20th century music, each piece highlights a different series of emotion that shows off the trumpet in a different way. That first piece was Sonata for Trumpet and Piano by Eric Oasen, and it was commissioned in 1995 by the International Trumpet Guild. We will now be taking a brief intermission, and I look forward to seeing you all at the second half. This next piece you will be hearing is by a Hungarian composer named Frigyes Hidas. The Trumpet Fantasy was commissioned in 1984 by the Hungarian Ministry of Culture for the International Trumpet Competition. I love that this piece features the fast technical side of trumpet playing as well as the smooth and lyrical side. It is such a fun piece to perform with piano, and each transition brings more and more excitement. I hope you enjoy Fantasy for Trumpet. Thank you. This next piece that I will be playing was originally written for euphonium and piano, but one of my friends played it for their recital last year, and I thought that it would be perfect for flugelhorn. This piece holds a special place in my heart because it is written by a Canadian composer. I first played a piece by Kate Nishimura in 2017 when I was in the National Youth Band of Canada, and we played her piece Chasing Sunlight. Her compositions are often nature-inspired and extremely accessible to audiences. There's just something about her writing that everyone can relate to. Tundra is a piece inspired by the cold north, reminding me of my home, but it is also about depression, and it highlights a feeling of emptiness and stillness. As many of you know, I lost my grandfather at the end of October, which was a difficult time for the whole family. It completely turned our lives upside down, inside out, and I know many of us felt that emptiness and despair that is associated with grief. Even though he can't be with us today, I know that he's watching us and that he is so proud of how far we've come. I love this piece because it's almost like you can hear the glistening of the snow and the ice crystals forming through the piano lines. And I really hope that you enjoy Tundra by Kate Nishimura.
Thank you.
we conclude tonight's program, I wanted to take the time to say a few thank yous. Firstly, I want to thank my family and friends. Family is so important to me, and I would not be here without their love and support. This is my dad's first time flying on an airplane in over 20 years, and he came down to see my recital, which was a really big deal for him, and I'm so happy that he was able to make it. My mom, my brother, Baba, Dito, Bernice, back home in Winnipeg, who are all watching on the live stream. Byron in LA, my aunts, uncles, cousins, the list goes on and on. As a Ukrainian family, we have a strong community and so much love and support for each other. And we have great parties. I wanted to thank my teachers. I have so many of them who have helped me grow into a stronger musician. This includes Professor Rom, Dr. Gillereth, Professor Tito Carrillo, Professor Duvall, and Dr. Carol Dawn Reinhardt. Thank you for your continuous support and for always pushing me to be the best trumpet player that I can be. I want to thank Hannah Freeman Choi for being an amazing piano player and working so hard to put this recital together. She always brings her A-game to every single rehearsal and performance. I wanted to thank Josh and Jacoby for helping with backstage and page turning and for being such supportive friends. I wanted to thank Aaron at the front desk and Nathan in they do all of the behind the scenes work. So everything that goes on in this school, everything that happens, it happens because of them. And I really appreciate that. And I don't think that they always get the recognition for the work that they do. Finally, I wanted to thank everyone who came in person, everyone who tuned in online. I appreciate your support so much, and I am really, really happy that I am able to share this music with you tonight. If you have not gotten enough trumpet playing tonight, the Symphony Orchestra is going to be performing in 1 hour at Krannert, and the program is going to be really, really fun. We're playing Korngold, Copland, and we're finishing off the evening with West Side Story by Leonard Bernstein. So it's definitely something that you don't want to miss. The final piece on my program for tonight is Oliver's Birthday by Bruce Broughton. I emailed the composer earlier this week to let him know that I was playing the piece and that I was enjoying it. And he told me that it was written for his stepson, Oliver, when he was really young. And because Oliver was so excited for his upcoming birthday. It is supposed to highlight the feeling of joy and excitement that Oliver was feeling and just have an overall bright and sunny atmosphere throughout the piece. I hope you enjoyed the program tonight, and I am looking forward to seeing you all at the orchestra concert.